Mendes has sent us to the Merchants League counting house in the city of Baldur's Gate. We are to obtain their sea charts for him. The counting house should be located in the northeastern quadrant of the city. I was glad that we checked that out first. We went here first.
Go pester someone else.
So we don't have to check, go back there again.
Hey, how are things going?
Nothing of interest.
Sure.
Callahan. Hello, mates. Callahan I be. Scores of fish in the seven seas. Ain't seen you before. Knew you be? A briny beard and a sea chanty in my breath. Indeed, it is my first visit to lovely Olgoth's Beard, situated on the lovely Sword Coast, a short carriage ride from downtown Baldur's Gate. A silver tongue you have. The beard is lovely as a mule's ass, and it smells like a 10-day fish. Welcome all. May the fleas be kind to the and the ladies kinder. Thank you, good sir. 'Tis nothing. You look a mite floundered, mates. Can I be of assistance? Really? Nay, filthy one. Ah, you can. Know ye Mendes of Waterdeep? Mendes, eh? He's a grim sort. Ne'er a kind word or a... How's your auntie? I assume that you know him. Perhaps you can spare your perceptions of the fellow. I have known him for as long as he'd been in the beard, but I remember better with a little gold in me palm. I see. Will 20 gold suffice? Aye, it will. Go ahead, then. Mendes came to the beard this season past. Bought old Svensson's place, he did. He claimed to be from Waterdeep, but I known fellows for the city of splendors, and they could speak the common tongue as good as I done. As well as I do, you mean? Nay, better. Yeah, I thought it was... Talks weird, you know, especially for a scholar. Wherever he's from, Mendes darn to like to mix with us common folk. He keeps to himself. In his house, for the most part. He leaves for a few days every month, is all. That's all I've been knowing, I'm afraid. A bloody miracle worker you be. Many thanks to you, and may the fish find your bait most delectable. 'Tis the least a lad could do. Good day to you all. Mendes says he came to Olgoth's Beard from Waterdeep. But Callahan says he doesn't have a Waterdavian accent. Mendes must be from somewhere else. Can we ask him about this? A salty sea dog by the name of Callahan tells us that Mendes, the scholar from Waterdeep, keeps to himself and is away several days a month on business.
Sure.
I know nothing more that will help you, but I could get those sea charts for you for an appropriate amount of gold, of course. How do you know about that? Do you want the old Callahan to be of assistance with the charts? How much do you want? Well, let me think of all the costs. The journey, the food, the lodging, the little mermaid. If you give him 5,000 gold coins, I'll bring you the charts. What? Did you fall off your chair too many times? The whole journey I am planning will only cost parts of this sum. Leave me be. As you wish, you tight-fisted clam. I'd be anchoring a bit, in case you change your mind. Really. I'd rather do it myself anyway, just curious.
All right.
I have waited long for such as you.
I was thinking we might be able to ask him about what
sure.
We found out, but...
All right.
Nope. Alright, so that's Mendes' home, Shandalar's home, Thorella's home, and Olgoth's Beard Inn. Alright.
Why me? Alright.
Hmm. this? This tower has long been deserted. There is nothing but rubble within. Another commoner.
Keep it quick. I ain't got time to dawdle.
It's the guy who talked. Same guy, I guess. Or the same, different guy saying the same thing about seeing Fenris at the docks. Oh, we can walk around here. Well, that's it. That's the whole place. Now, what about this guy who was looking? Is that Shandalar? Well, that's his house. Looking for his cloak. We're going on some kind of adventure, and he doesn't say where we're going or what this is all about, really.
What do you need?
Are you ready for your task now? Yes, I will leave right now. You're on your way, then. When you've located my cloak, return to where you arrived, and this ward token will affect your release, your passage back. Off you go now. What? Oh. You've been teleported by Shandalar far up to the north, on an island lost within the ice floes of the Northern Ocean. And here's a bear, a polar bear. Entrance to dungeon, okay.
Sure.
That narrows it down. Where the hell are we? Are we near Icewind Dale or something? Alright, I guess we're going to this dungeon. Oh, wait a second. What did he give us? Another ward stone. So what we have is these ward stones. We were awarded with a ward stone. Oh, there's a winter wolf. Telen? Who's this? Bane, or Bean, Telan, and Andris, protected from normal missiles. Well, somehow, I have the feeling that we're protected from normal missiles. So maybe not use normal missiles. But rather magical ones. Can't save.
Sure.
For right. And I owe you.
Give us victory!
Where are these people? Oh. These don't stack, unfortunately.
Sure.
What place is this?
All right.
Looking for any secrets.
Hey, how are things going?
Oh. What happened?
Why me?
Yep. All right, all right.
Look for this guy's cloak. This doesn't show up that I can see.
Fine. All right.
Oh boy. Andra says, "Well, well, well. I sense the ripples, and there you are. But you are something new. Tell me, friend, how come you to this place?" Probably the same way you did. Why don't you tell me your story and see if it's the same as mine? You are just the latest teleporting fool to be captured. This place seems a magnet of sorts. If you are powerful enough to transport without error across an ocean, you are apparently of sufficient power to be caught and dragged here. It is the very place that does it... seems to ensnare the energy. Needless to say, leaving the island by magical means seems entirely impossible. You will get used to seabird eggs if you wish to survive. Who constructed such a place? What is its purpose? I don't know an answer to either question. It could be a joke of the gods, or a test, or both. It's hard to tell with gods. It could be a natural phenomenon, although these tunnels certainly are not. Trapped mages may have fashioned them for shelter, however. There is little else to do here except plot, study, or go mad. I prefer to plot. On that note, if you'd be so kind as to strip down and give me what you're carrying, I would be ever so grateful. If you want my equipment, you're going to have to take it. Certainly. First you, then the others here. I need all the power I can get. I don't mind taking by force. Oh, brother.
Why me?
Dimension door. Okay. Just in case. Fear. Is this fear? Attack!
Tempest, give us victory!
Oh, God! Ah, Kagan. is attacking us. Kagan attacking me, right?
Such menial.
Marcellus. Dire Charm and Acid. Did that work before when it uncharmed? Whoever was charmed. Pretty tough. Stop this dwarf from going after us.
Butt kicking for goodness!
Get stuck up
in the get stuck in.
Oh, because he's not with us. Oh, he's fine now.
All right.
Holy crap, Aurelio. Pretty sure that's all our healing. What is that? Aid? Or fatigue now?
Go pester someone else. Sure.
Can we rest out here?
Sure.
I don't know. Yeah, apparently. Let's see if anything attacks us, like the polar bear. Okay, we're good.
Sure.
Polar bear left us alone.
All right.
Resist fear. When we get close.
I need an ale. Sure.
I guess I'll cast Bless. Oh, the... Ah, we missed some stuff, some gold. I think that's just a standard, like, traveler's robe or protection from whatever robe. Missed it. I left the place instead. I was kind of... just wanted to get the hell out of here. Is this Bless?
Why me?
Okay, because we haven't killed the guy who was talking to us. There he is. Damn it. Who's this? Beam? Wait, what's going on with me? Hold on. I am confused. Oh, I killed him? Nice. The dino here did anyway.
I don't wanna talk.
Let's get Bean. Level up for Minsk. Oh crap. Oh crap. Minsk! Oh, he's hitting me, and I can't move. Can I do something about this? Other than kill him? Oh, I'm the one who has the Wand of Paralyzation. Can't move yet. Did we kill that guy? I think we killed Bean. Yeah, we did. Now, if we can just not get killed by Minsk, that'd be great.
My blade will cut you down to size.
I am wounded.
Come on, lady, move! Damn it! I don't know if we can make it. Damn it. We're stumbling into a winter wolf. I still can't move. Who's getting hit? Minsk attacking Branwyn.
A simple matter.
We're okay. We're okay. I think we're okay.
Mud kicking for goodness.
We are. Okay, good.
Why me?
Who's this? Oh, it's a hobgoblin. Okay. You can't pick up what is near. Remove magic, grease, protection from evil scrolls, and Andrus's journal. 109 gold. Some kind of mage robe.
All right.
I prefer to take this stuff. I don't know why we can't pick up nearby like we normally could.
What? A simple matter.
Protection from evil. One creature, yeah. Grease. Remove magic. This is the combat version of Dispel Magic. It will only affect opponents. Remove magic dispels the magical effects upon any enemies within the area. This includes effects given from spells, potions, and certain magical items such as wands. It does not, however, affect enchanted magical items. The chance of the dispel succeeding is determined by the level of the caster and the level of the magic being dispelled. The base chance of successfully dispelling is 50%. For every level that the caster of removed magic is above the original caster, her chance of success increases by 5%. It's basically the same thing as dispel magic. While this spell dispels the individual effects of grease, web, stinking cloud, and other such spells, it does not dispel the area of effect. Alright. That's cool. She'll hold on to that. Oop. What else?
Yes, a simple matter.
Okay, the robe. It's a knave's robe. Okay. Nothing that great. Andrus's journal. The journal of Andrus of Erebor. Would that I had more paper to write upon, but much was burned in haste for warmth. Little there is to document anyway, and so I leave this small writ for any that might find my corpse, for that is the only way it shall part from me. And it has. Know that Andrus does curse you for your life, and that, should I return in some fell form, I will hunt you for the sheer spite of you seeing my decimated body. The business of that aside, I hope that you who read this have suffered the same fate as I. The indignity of this condition. With all the power at mine fingers, I must huddle around a dung fire eating seal fat. The forces behind this place have no respect for my stature, my power. I have slain beasts thrice my size with a glance, and traveled as a bird over oceans. Here my magic is sucked to the earth, and I am held, as others are. Some have escaped, and I swear I shall hunt them and take the power they must have. To do what I cannot, they must be great indeed. I curse them for leaving. I curse this place, and I curse that I have not the might to follow. Andrus of Erebor. Well, that was interesting. So where's the other guy?
All right.
He was over here. Oh yeah. Okay, we know this is a wand of fear. And some gold. Dagger. Doing daggers. Oh, and summon stuff went away. I wanna go
Why me?
I want to go outside and identify these ward stones and such. Well, we have some hope here because it says that some people have
gather your party before venturing forth.
Have escaped. So, if they escaped, maybe we can escape. We still have this cure Sirius, yeah. Oh! I wanted to cure him, not level him up, but that's fine. So, yeah. Saves reduced by one, Thaco by one, more, seven more hit points. Done. Okay, thank you very much. Now I would like to heal him. That helps. Let's see. How many things do I have to identify? I'm surprised I wouldn't know this. But I don't know it. Okay, so we've got these three ward stones. This cloak, and that, so I got six things. Yep. I'm crazy about it, sorry. There you go. So what'd I say? Six things? Yes. At least this is a safe place to rest. This thing doesn't bother us. I know it's called a polar bear. Alright, the wardstone. Dwarven rune wardstone. A rather generic looking dwarven rune wardstone. This could have any number of uses. And we know this is another wand of fear. This is cloak of protection plus one. The simple cloak has been imbued with some small magical properties to help protect its wearer. It does so by affecting both saving throws and armor class. It is ideal for mages and others who cannot wear bulkier or more restrictive types of armor. So armor class and saving throws plus one. So that would go here. Yeah, I'll take that. Oh, this cannot be equipped due to other magical equipment you are currently wearing. Same. Okay, that's disappointing. Well, she already has a cloak. Oh, she has regular? That's right, I gave her that. Or those. Trying to see if anyone can wear this cloak. Who has it now? She can wear it. Armor class -2. Yeah, I'll willingly give that to her. That's fine. Because she gets hit. She gets damaged a lot easier than the fighter types, and I always send her into battle. That's how that works. So we got this. We got that. I'm kind of starting to run out of room here. We'll be dropping arrows. Let me see, they're all the same. Dwarven stones. Shandalar's wardstone. This wardstone is a magical component to a recall type spell. When the possessor of this stone also has Shandalar's cloak, the stone will activate and transport the possessor and her companions back to the maid Shandalar. The stone's magic will only work in open air, not underground. Wardstone forgery? Is this the one that guy sold us? Upon closer examination, what once looked to be a wardstone now only appears to be a gem of mediocre value with several symbols carved upon the outer edge. This forgery is excellent work and would fool all but the most diligent observer. Wonderful. And there's another dwarven runestone. But I can't stack them with other dwarven runestones. I wonder if I can just... Oh, I can. Cool. That helps. There's all this stuff to sell. And arrows. I want to use this up. Alright, now let's... put our spells back. Looking forward to Cloud Kill. Anyone else level up? Let's see now. Okay. Resting again. Good.
Go past us. All right.
I'm glad we can rest out there.
Why me?
Just makes things a lot easier.